As the FBI released these first images of the aftermath of Monday's rescue, they also revealed chilling details of how much danger the 5-year-old victim and agents faced when they stormed in. Authorities say they found not one, but two explosive devices, one in the bunker and another in a PVC pipe. One of the photos showed what looked to be the bunker's collapsed roof. The FBI says Jimmy Lee Dykes had purposely reinforced his hideout to keep anyone from getting in. But authorities were able to get in, and CNN has pieced together how they did it. For days, from a command center at a nearby church, negotiators spoke with Dykes over a telephone. A source characterized Dykes as contentious the entire time. Even so, he allowed authorities to deliver so-called comfort items. The kidnapper even earned the gratitude of the local sheriff.
He's also allowed us to provide coloring books, medication, toys. And I want to thank him for taking care of our child.
According to law enforcement sources, authorities used a camera to monitor what was going on inside the bunker, but won't say how they got the camera inside. An FBI source tells CNN surveillance drones were used to observe the site from above, round the clock. While special FBI hostage rescue teams rehearsed over and over possible assault scenarios, but it was Sunday when the countdown to Monday's operation started ticking down, as negotiators sensed a change in Dykes' demeanor.
Within the past 24 hours, negotiations deteriorated.
It's what agents saw next that triggered the operation.
Mr. Dykes was observed holding a gun.
The hostage rescue teams went into action.
I heard a big boom, and then I believe I heard rifle shots.
At this point, FBI agents, fearing the child was in imminent danger, entered the bunker and rescued the child.
Sources tell CNN federal agents detonated large explosions. Then, two or more agents dropped into the bunker, shooting Dykes multiple times, killing him. 5-year-old Ethan was unharmed. It was all over in seconds.
We appreciate everybody in law enforcement pulling together to get this job done. Thank you.
Hundreds of federal and local law enforcement agents from Alabama to Washington deserve credit for saving Ethan. This morning, as classes resumed at his elementary school in Midland City, one more name was added to that list. Charles Poland, the bus driver many regard as a hero, who died trying to keep Dykes from his young passengers.
He gave the ultimate sacrifice for those students on his bus. And his last child is now home.
Martin Savage, CNN, Midland City, Alabama.